We're going to make the story even more exciting. And that's also this week's theme, namely how to use Scratch to tell stories. Further in the instructional strategies module, I will come back to that. But first, we will practice our coding. So now, it will be really nice if Carl can respond to Hassan. We can do this in the same way as we did earlier. So we will place a wait block right here. Remember, that's at the control section. So we get a wait block and we place it followed by another say block. So you go back to looks and you grab the say block. And again, the same question for you. How many seconds do you think Carl has to wait? What do you think? Yeah, that is 2 seconds again. If you have difficulties answering these questions correctly, you can always test this yourself by clicking the green flag. So if I do it now, for example, hello, coding kids. Hi, I'm Hassan. Hello. Goes too fast. So that's why we make this 2 seconds. And after that, it's Carl's turn. I already placed the say block underneath, but what will Carl actually say? Let's have a look. Hello, coding kids. Wait for 2 seconds. Say, do you want to play with me? There we go. Okay. Now you're getting a real conversation, a story. So you can try and watch it by clicking the green flag. So let's do that. Hello, coding kids. Hi, I'm Hassan. Do you want to play with me? But unfortunately, Hassan doesn't really feel like playing. Hassan would rather code computer programs. So Hassan tells Carl, nah, I'm sorry, buddy. I'd rather code. So we do the same thing. Wait for 1 second. And the rest is actually your assignment. So code this in the conversation in Scratch, and I believe you can do it. I'll see you in the next video.